Our next comedian has never been on Jay Leno, David Letterman, or on Def Comedy Jam. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Bart Mower.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Carlos, and I work here at the Murray Theater. Bart wanted me to come on and let you know that he's going to be a little detained. He told me to tell you it's because he's helping a blind lady to find her seat. But that's a lie. I'm not going to lie to you. So the truth is, you know when you're really nervous and you have like a nervous beat? Okay, well he has that. And he was in a hurry, so he got a little wet spot. And he's like, oh man, I cannot go out there like this, man. I'm like, no man, you gotta do it. Man, you gotta go. He's like, no man, there's no way. I said, listen man, these people know you, man. They love you. They don't care if you beat your pants. Just go out there, man. He's like, no man, I'm not gonna do it. I said, you gotta do it. He said, I'm not gonna do it. He could be a while too, man. The last time I saw him, he was in the men's room and looked like he was dating the hand dryer. Oh, okay. He's ready to go. All right, let's start the show. First, I just want to thank Carlos for stepping in for me. I don't know if he mentioned to you what happened, but there was a blind lady and she helped to her seat, so I feel good that I was able to help her. So, anyway, Carlos is from Los Angeles. Anybody else here from California? Anybody? Good, because California sucks. It does. It is so dangerous there. You know, there's areas of California that if you go into them, you're going to get beaten up or killed, right? In fact, I heard there's areas that the police won't even go into them, which is just messed up. But in Utah, I can go in, you can take me and drop me off anywhere, night or day, and I can feel perfectly safe walking around. And you can say, well, that's not true because it's dangerous here in Utah as well. But I bet if you go to the areas that are dangerous and you talk to the people who live there, they're from California. Because all the gang activity comes from California. You think about it. I mean, you never hear about gangs coming from any other state. I mean, when's the last time you heard about a guy getting beaten up from a gang from Idaho? You know, he's like walking along, and I was like, what was that? So I threw something at me. It's a potato. Oh, no. It's the Boise Crips. Run! Boise Crips. And if you remember the Boise Crips, I'm just kidding. You know. But anyway, I recently went shopping at Walmart because I'm a loser. But no, I was there to buy a toilet seat. This is a true story because I broke the one that I had. I was leaning to one side and I cracked it. So, yeah, I'm not proud. Yeah. So I'm in the toilet seat aisle, okay? And it's kind of impressive. They've had this 20-foot display of all these different varieties of toilet seats. But what I noticed is there's different sizes of toilet seats, right? And I didn't think about measuring my toilet before I came, you know? So I'm thinking they need to have like they have in the shoe department. You know that metal thing you use to measure your foot? Just a big one for your butt. Just one. Well, looks like I'm getting the Oprah. So after I picked up my crap saddle, I went over to the grocery side of the store, and they have a product over there. It's called Some Dude's Fry Sauce. Have you heard of this stuff? Yeah, I've never tried it. It's probably good. It probably tastes like water circles. I don't know. But I was thinking, you know, if it was my company, I would branch out. I would sell peanuts in a bag and call it Some Dude's Nutsack. Hello? Yeah, this is Bart. Yeah, I was gonna call you guys. I can make a payment on Friday. No, not the full amount. How much is the back payment? Yeah, I'll pay that on Friday. Mm-hmm. Yeah, all the information is the same. Okay. Yeah, you too. Bye. Even get this number. I mean, it's not even a real phone. I just recently got a tattoo. Thank you. Yeah, my former bishop's sitting over there, so tattoo. But actually, the new bishop's here as well. I got old bishops here. But you know, I got a tattoo. It's a self portrait. And it's life size. I think it looks just like me. All right, I'm going to play a song now on the guitar. So it's going to take a second to set this up. So, okay, or if you happen to be managing a famous rock band, okay, this is what you'll do. Okay, do a music video of a concert. Get a concert video. And in the video, have the song start off with like simple finger picking for like 20 seconds, and then have a hard power chord, like, okay? And at that moment, the people that are closest to the stage have them fall back, and then have it just like a reverberation through the whole crowd. It's like a wave that just takes everybody down. That would be cool, right? But what would be really cool is that when you go and do it live in concert, and you start playing the song, the people will be like, oh, that's that song from the video. Right? And then when you hit that power chord, everybody will do it live. That would be awesome. Okay. So if you are, just go ahead, you know, take that. You know.